So at the last tribal council, Sandra's voted out. Varner, you seem to think that it meant you would be next.
Yeah, I mean, that's logical. Wouldn't you say? Well, I'm on the bottom. I'm next. I tried my best to not be next, but it doesn't look like that worked.
You know because you know you're on the bottom.
I know. I've had conversations with everybody in this group today. I know I'm going home tonight.
Debbie, that got a reaction from you.
Yeah, when somebody is that certain, a little feeling of unease just creeps over me. Like, I'm just trying to prepare myself to be absolutely shocked tonight.
Jeff, tell me what happened at camp. Did everybody just say, Barney, you're going home?
I went and talked to each person individually after the challenge today. I've been talking to people for the last 2.5 days. I feel like I knew where people stood. I felt like I was getting in the cracks. I felt like I was moving off the bottom. But it was revealed to me today how little I knew about what actually is going on here at Old Camp. They are not six strong because I've been arguing all day long, who do you want to vote out? Half the group says, if you get enough numbers to vote Ozzy, I'll vote Ozzy. Because Ozzy is a strategic threat. He is the total package. So it began to reveal itself to me that there was a secret alliance between Zeke and Ozzy. Okay? There is deception going on right here. And you guys are the victims of it. Bottom of the alliance. Boom, boom, and boom. Bottom. So I am proposing tonight, vote for Ozzy. We'll take care of the whole situation. If you will vote, and you will vote, and you will vote, I'll hook us up. That's the pitch I'm making to you today. There is deception here.
Yeah.
Deception on levels, Jeff, that these guys don't even understand. There's more.
Continue.
Why haven't you told anyone you're transgender? I'm showing is a deception.
But that's personal.
It has nothing to do with the game.
That's personal. You didn't have to do that.
That is so wrong. We are you to bring that up.
I'm not using that as anything negative.
That has nothing to do with the game. That's personal.
I'm not knocking him.
That's not deception. You just...
Yeah, that was just so revealed to whom he wanted.
I argue for the rights of transgender people every day in the state of North Carolina. I would never say or do anything to hurt anyone here. Jeff, I'm arguing for my life. I feel like I've got to throw everything in the wall.
Outing somebody is...
I'm not outing him.
You are outing him. Nobody has the right to out anybody.
I agree with Ty. It was for Zeke to discuss when he was comfortable discussing it.
The two seasons that quit survived, right?
Nobody.
I don't want the perception to be that I'm this evil, hateful person.
What was your goal in doing that?
To show the deception.
That isn't deceiving us strategically in a game. I don't think so.
It reveals the ability to deceive.
Jeff, when you say that by revealing that Zeke is transgender, you're proving that he's deceptive.
I'm not saying, Jeff, that transgender people are deceptive.
No, you're saying by him not revealing it, that he's capable of deception. That is a giant leap of logic. Do you honestly not see that?
I do see that, and I feel horrible about it. I'm just trying everything that I can, and I'm so sorry, Zeke. I support you.
Jeff, you can't unring the bell.
I'm not unringing the bell. I'm just apologizing, Jeff.
Jeff, you should be ashamed of yourself.
I am.
You should be ashamed of yourself for what you're willing to do to get yourself further in a game for $1 million. It's like you're playing with people's lives at this point.
And I'm so sorry, Zeke.
Jeff, when you look at Zeke's expression, who typically is very connected, and now, just visually to me, looks a little bit like he's on an island of his own.
Nothing to do with the game.
That is so wrong.
We are
wrong. Nobody has the right to out anybody.
And he was voted out. Darn it. Trump spoke. 13 are left. Who will be voted out tonight?
Forgive Varner, and I don't forgive that guy yet.
Okay.
And it's okay if
you do.
I want to give Varner a little.
suffer. It's just compassionate.
I
that's
understand
who I am.
That's okay. And I don't care that you did that.
Yeah.
And I hope you're not mad at me for not.
Absolutely not.
So,
he took away so much from Zeke. You know, thinking about it right now, I'm like a little bit emotional about it.
You know, I come from a very conservative background. I don't know any transgender people until now. And the fact that I've been with Zeke and gotten to know him as a person from day one, I love that guy. And it doesn't change who he is to me. If anything, it makes us stronger, I feel. So I woke up this morning and Zeke is Zeke. I almost don't feel like it's real. I only know you as Zeke. You know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah, I just, like, I didn't want people to, like, cry and yell. And so I was just like, all right.
No, but that wasn't cool.
I was very touched by how everyone responded. One of the reasons I didn't tell people is I sort of wanted people to see me as myself. Often in my life, when I tell people I'm trans, that's sort of what they're interested in. And everything else about me sort of gets pushed to the wayside. But, you know, Survivor, it makes you tough, it makes you resilient, and it makes you adaptable. And I think I've had all those qualities before, but they've certainly been strengthened and grown. And I think I was able to be a little more brave and a little bolder to help others and also to get over my own fears and to get over my own, you know, issues and complexes and insecurities with being transgender.
I'm glad it's, you know, we moved past that.
Yeah. Closer together. You know, I really like the people I'm playing with, and it is heartening in this game that often your lowest moments, you know, when something bad does happen to you, that people who are out to get you in some regard do stand in your defense, do come to your defense, and I was truly touched. But in the meantime, there's still a task at hand, a task that I'm rather committed to. I'm here to win $1 million. I'm here to play Survivor, so let's just get back to it. I'll tell the Varner story. Here's the thing. We get to tribal council, and we're not 5 minutes in before Varner takes it upon himself to say, Zeke is deceiving you. Because what Zeke is not telling you is that Zeke is transgender.
That's what he says?
Which?
And it's true.
No one.
I am. Though it happened in a way that I wasn't crazy about, I think I'm like all of you, and forever changed and forever evolved by my experience on Survivor, and was a much stronger and more capable person in that moment.
Awesome. Good deal.
I was so proud of Zeke. It's amazing. More respect for Zeke in telling his story than I do for a handful of these jokers in knowing them for 20 days. And I think Zeke is right. The experience of going on Survivor, it makes you tough. And nothing is gonna be easy about the merge. There are 13 people at this camp. And now the game at hand is figure out where people stand and who's in the loop and who's out of it.